And welcome back to the Emtronia One, and today is day 312 of the Snake Diet Multiverse, in which I ballsed it up. I haven't completely ballsed it up, but I've ballsed it up. This morning I looked at the scales and I came in at 288 pounds. And the absolute worst thing is it 20 to 1, I think?
Yes.
Nearly 20 to 1. And I'm starving. And I'm only starving because all weekend and all week, last week, I've been hitting cakes, chocolate, biscuits, chippy, takeaways. I had so many Christmas cakes, it's unbelievable. Kept saying to myself, we're going to start this diet tomorrow, and eat. And then I've come today and I'm like, oh, I'm starving. I just want to eat loads of food. But today, it's day fast zero, because this diet ain't just a, to stop myself getting diabetes. Because I accidentally found that when I did keto, for instance, and fasting, mainly, fasting is really good, it's better than keto, that it brought my anxiety. I have anxiety 24/7, so, and I've had that since I was a kid. I believe I know why I've had it since I was a kid, but it's true or not, but I'm not going to tell you, it's all in your face. So I've got it 24/7, and, but it tends to be really low down. But along about 10, 20 years ago, it was always high. So I was crippled, basically, mentally crippled. But I've managed to bring it all the way down over the years, and now I'm 41 years. I mean, then when I got to about, I think about 34, 35, I was told I was going to get diabetes and stuff, and I needed one medication, and I got side effects off it. And that's when I went on the keto diet and trying to find out about the keto diet. And when I sustained it for like about 4 or 5 months, I noticed, I woke up one morning, I was like, bloody hell, where's my anxiety gone? Now, it was still there, and I didn't realise at the time, but it was really, really, really low down. So my anxiety, so before that, it was like about there. So I got it to about there, you see, even though it was all the way up here. I forgot why I was going on about this, because I've been eating carbs, I've been eating chocolate, I've been eating cake, and it's affecting my memory. It is really, really affecting my memory right now. I'm really bad. I'm struggling with my memory. And because I'm struggling with my memory, I'm getting irritable. And every time I hear a noise, like a plane, like a thing in a cup, a spoon in a cup, if I drop something, if I accidentally bang myself or something like that, my brain goes straight up, you know. It tries to jump out my brain to, what the fuck? It tries to make me go crazy. So, yeah. So, that's what it is. Because I've been eating all these carbs and stuff, my anxiety has been going from pretty much down here. It hasn't... A couple of times it's gone shut up like that, but what it's been doing is, see, I suffer with two other things. One of them is visual snow syndrome, in which most of the time I don't realise it's there. I haven't been diagnosed with that, by the way. I'm the type of person who gets something, read up on something. I used to ask the doctor ages ago, and he used to go, oh, I take it here, you're on nutcase medication, so you must be a nutcase, you know what I mean? I personally think I got misdiagnosed, but that's my own thing. So, yeah, there's a plane outside now. So, I get this visual snow syndrome. When my anxiety goes up, the syndrome goes up. Or the flashy of the lights and stuff. It's always there. Always flashy lights. It's always like that TV with all the little pixels on it. Just like that. But it only affects is when I get the anxiety. Or when I don't realise I'm getting... And then he goes and shouts, and it's just gone. I don't know if you heard that, my uncle who I look after, he just shouted, My belly went all the way up here. It's like being a shock to the system, and it's gone to my head, and it's like, I just want to throw the phone out the window. And I think that's all because of the chocolate I've been eating, the carbs, the cakes and stuff like that. It's really affecting me bad. But like I say, I forgot where I was up to because it's affecting my memory. I'm just losing my memory because of the carbs. And because of the carbs, it's affecting my stress levels, my anxiety levels, my snow globe thing is coming up to the surface, and the more it comes up, the more I feel like I'm getting, like the anxiety is turning into a stone sensation. It's like it's trying to make you high and talk drunk or something like that. And then it makes you ramble, and I'm rambling and talking about this when I should be talking about the diet. So you see what I mean? And I have something else called depersonalization, which you get anxiety, and then all of a sudden you get high anxiety, and then you get this depersonalization thing. Except for me, I've been getting low anxiety, and the depersonalization has been going whoosh. And at the last couple of weeks, I thought it might have been, well, I ain't been getting anxiety, and we've been getting depersonalization because it's in reverse. And then I realized, wait a minute, you always have anxiety, but it's always there. It's just that you train yourself to forget it's there, and then when the depersonalization shoots up because you've forgotten the anxiety was there, you think, oh, it's going in reverse. But then you've got to ask yourself, is wait a minute, if I'm getting all this crap from the anxiety, shouldn't my anxiety be higher? And then you realize it is high, and it's like, mother, you see what I mean? It's like, what, why was my anxiety high in the first place? It makes no sense. So even though it's technically not in reverse, because there's something weird going on in my brain. I think it's because I fixed my brain the best I could without the help of the doctors, because they're all complete idiots, you know, in my opinion, because I'm opinionated. And the stress of everything now is because I put a shield in my brain based on my craziness. And my craziness is now trying to get out, but it's stuck in the shield thing. But at the same time, my brain is saying, wait a minute, what if you go back to being crazy again? And it's saying, but hey, what about this voice? Let's have some carbs, let's all feel better and forget about it, because food makes you forget about shit. So I'm in a perpetual circle of madness, even though I'm not actually mad, so it's going back the other way around. So one side of the brain is going crazy but can't actually escape, while the other side of the brain is defending and got this magical shield, but they're worried that it might come in. So you're worried for absolutely no reason at all, just because I've been eating cake, carbs, pasties and chippy. And that is my ultimate excuse to why I'm now £288, because I'm looking after multiple people and forgetting to look after myself, while the multiple people who I'm looking after are affecting me mentally, but they're not actually affecting me mentally, because I'm affecting myself mentally by choosing to eat chocolate and stuff to cause this craziness to happen. I hope I made a lot of sense in there. So yeah, I've caused it to myself, but today is day 50, and I'm hoping that I can get out of this bubble of madness, which is not really mad, but it is a bubble, but the craziness is touching the sides. Yeah, I hope this explains it through, because I know if I told this to a doctor, they'd probably lock me up, because they're the ones who are crazy. So this is the Emtronia one, with a nice little update of the state diet. I've balls it up, but awfully today is the day I unballs it up and shoot for the moon. See you later.